and you join us here at Offshore Europe 2023, SPE Offshore Europe, and we're here on the Net Zero Technology Stand. We're joined by Myrtle Myrtle. Hello, how are you? Looking forward to four good days here today?
Yeah, it's just fantastic. It's absolutely buzzing. Of course, we've got this fabulous stand, not just ourselves, but here with our developers and some of their fantastic equipment and some of the fantastic companies that we've been accelerating.
Now, first of all, tell us a little bit about the Net Zero Technology Centre. For those who don't know who you are and what you do.
Yeah, so we were formed as part of the Aberdeen City Region deal, so we're funding by both governments. And our mission is around using technology to accelerate net zero. And what we've been doing over the past 6-7 years is we've been looking at technology grant funding developers so that they can bring on the next generation of technology. And we've been also doing that for companies. And so we've had over 35 technologies commercialized to date. We've had five cohorts go through our business, and some of those companies are here today with some what I would call groundbreaking technology, which is really going to make a difference for the future.
Well, that's really exciting, isn't it? Because this is the 50th Offshore Europe.
Yeah.
It's 50 years, and that to me is 50 years of innovation, and that really is what you've got today. So how many companies and cohorts do you have with you?
So at the front, we're throughout the week, we're doing it in themes. So today, we're looking at asset integrity. And at the front, you can see all the companies that have got all this new technology. We call it non-intrusive, which means that you can just take a small gun and move it across a pipe and find out what's going on. And the reason this is important is, first of all, it uses the current technologies that we have, but it also uses the current supply chain. So the people who are out there are people who've been working in the industry, and they're the ones offering these services going forward. And let's face it, even with transition, we're still going to want to keep things in pipes like hydrogen and carbon dioxide. So this technology is fundamental to keeping us safe, as well as to reusing the infrastructure that we've already got.
Now, talking of innovation, this is a very exciting looking stand.
Yes.
That you have behind us here. And, an innovation with virtual reality, is that right?
Yes. So part of what we do also is how can we use digital and data to make things cheaper, smarter, faster, and really to keep people out of really dangerous situations. So what we've got here is augmented reality. So this is where you can be, you can see what's going on a plant, you can see the dials, and you can hear people and they can help you tell you what you need to do. What this does is it brings expertise to the individual in the plant rather than just have someone there, so others can be helping with the job. Really exciting. I'm a gamer. It looks like a game. I really think we should come and try it out.
I very much agree. Thank you for your time. It's been 50 years of SPE Offshore Europe, 50 years of innovation, and here an example of the innovation that will help power the next 50 years here at SPE Offshore Europe.